deep neural networks are able to adapt more complex data set. And it's better in generalizing previously unseen data. It's because of its multiple layer. That's why they are called deep. We will be explaining our project on diabetic retinopathy in 5 steps. 1. Data collection. 2. Preprocessing. 3. Training and validation. 4. Testing. 5. Deployment. Let's check about our data set. Our data set contain 2 parts. First, 2019 Kaggle data. Second, 2015 Kaggle data resized. Kaggle provide us this data. Link in the description below. So let's work in Kaggle notebook, because no need to download and bother about our PC spec. Let's jump into the code, search for Kaggle. Select notebook. Select new notebook. Create. Enable GPU and internet in the notebook. Let's upload our code in the Kaggle notebook, linked in the description below. Firstly, add data from competition APTOS 2019. Add weight file data by searching Densenet, or search by URL, link in the description below. Now let's add 2015 data set by searching URL, link in the description below. We are online ready to run the code. In pre-processing phase, we found that our data set has 5 classes, which are 0, no DR, 1, mild, 2, moderate, 3, severe, 4, proliferative drive. We combined 2015 data and 2019 data. We resized the images to 256x256, and then we applied Gaussian blur of kernel size 256x6. And we got images like this. By analyzing the data, we found it's highly unbalanced. Then we augmented the data. Data augmentation of one class aligned to the class with the most samples. So after augmentation we got 7,000 images in each class. In training and testing phase, we used Densenet 121, which gives us the best accuracy. As we told you before, we used Densenet 121. Weights are loaded in this code without top layer or last layer, to variable Densenet. Upon modeling the network, firstly we add Densenet to the model without the last layer. Then we design the last layer using global averaging 2D with a dropout of 0.5 and output of 5 nodes which represent each class. We used Atom optimization algorithm to optimize the weight on training. This is a summary of model. Here for demo we trained the model using 3 epochs. This is its training and validation accuracy. In order to make the result more stable we used a regression model too, and its accuracy is 77%. Our model got verified by the Kaggle and got an accuracy of 86.8%, made our Kaggle competition rank below 300. This is how we trained our model. Last phase deployment will be explained in the next video. Don't forget to like and subscribe.